Hi YouTube, Stu Dog here. Gonna be doing my YCS Milan review for 2014. So this was the second to last YCS of the year. I think there's one next week in Australia. So second to last YCS of the year slash format. So anyway, pretty standard stuff. There was, you know, a couple of shockers at this one, but you know, pretty much the standard stuff. So starting out with Burning Abyss, the best, well, from a lot of people say, best deck of the format, got 11 spots. And surprisingly, Shadolas, they got 11 spots too. So both got 11, so that's 22 already out of the top 32 just to these decks. So Shadolas, they are definitely not, you know, falling off the radar at all. Like, they are really good. El Shadol Fusion, I hate that card with a passion. And, you know, Fire Lake is another annoying card. But, I mean, Burning Abyss and Shadolas still up there is, you know, the best decks. So 11 spots each in the top 32. Going on to Quillput. Again, I don't own a Quillput card, so we're just going to use Fairy Wind to represent it. So, yeah, they got, I think, what, 9? Yeah, they got 9 spots out of the top 32. So, anyway, again, a lot of the dominance here. We got 31 out of the 32 spots, just the big three. And there is one other deck that topped, one other. And you're probably thinking, oh, it's probably Satellar Knights. But no, it was Evil Swarm. So Evil Swarm got in there as the other rogue deck, and it actually made it all the way to the top 8, surprisingly. So can't wait to see that deck list of the top 8 YCS Milan Evil Swarm deck list. So pretty interesting there. But in the end, it was Burning Abyss versus Quillput. There was another feature match. Like, again, this is a European YCS, so they're not doing the dumb top 16 draft thing, thankfully. But in the end, it was Burning Abyss versus Quillput, and Quillput ended up winning it 2-1, yeah. But, you know, just a really good, powerful deck, and it can basically beat anything. It has really powerful first-turn plays. Like, in the top 8 feature match, I think there was, again, Burning Abyss and Quillput, and the Quillput guy, he opened first turn towers games 1 and 3, so it was like, he didn't even get a chance to play the game, because, I mean, how does Burning Abyss get past first turn towers? Oh, yeah, they don't, because they literally have absolutely no outs to a first turn towers. Like, the guy tried to stall as long as he could, but he just could not, you know, find a way around the towers. Like, it's just that good against Burning Abyss, so Quillput, again, I think the towers is going to be going up in play. I mean, again, they have really good first turn openings with Scout and stuff consistent. And, I mean, Sacrifice, and they can utilize Vanity's Emptiness really, really well. So that's probably why it won. I think that's, yeah, its first YCS that it won. So awesome. Pendulums are officially good. Congrats, Konami. And, you know, onto the one shocker, I really expected at least one Satellar Knight to top. Like, come on, just one, but no. None got in there. I know some got feature matches, but, I mean, that was pretty much it. So, unfortunately, Satellar Knights, they couldn't get the job done this time with their new lovely Trevor, which is a really good card. And, I mean, that's pretty much all I got to say for this event. I mean, the coverage was amazing, the commentators were pretty good, and, you know, I also heard that Six Samurais 2-0'd Shadolas, and the Shadol guy was like a former YCS winner, so I mean, that must have been epic. I didn't even see it, but I heard that Six Sams, they just 2-0'd Shadolas, and it was just really, really funny. So, a lot of different highlights we get to see. First turn towers against Burning Abyss in top 8, and it just won the deal. And unfortunately, we didn't see any Evil Swarm feature matches, but I mean, they did get top 8. No Satellar Knights, which again was a pretty big shocker, but I mean, in the end, it was lovely, lovely Quillport that took it all and remained glorious. So, thank you guys for watching this YCS review as always, and next week, again, I'll have my last YCS review of the year for Australia, and that's all I gotta say. So, thank you guys for watching, and until next time, this is Stu Dog signing out.